Hello, my friend. Welcome to Breakfast with Sergio. This is episode number 293. And let me ask you, are you posting too much or you're posting too little? Are you overposting or underposting in social media? Let's talk about that today. Welcome to my breakfast table. Well, my friends, welcome back to Breakfast with Sergio. Super happy to have you on my breakfast table. I have with me carrot juice with orange, freshly, you know, squeezed orange and fresh also carrot juice, which I love. And I also have yogurt with nuts right here ready to eat. So great kind of way to start my day on this beautiful and awesome fall day. So let's talk about posting. Are you overposting or are you underposting on your social media, particularly Instagram, Facebook, wherever you may be at? Are you doing too much or are you not doing enough? That's one of the topics that I often address in my Next Level Academy, which is my coaching program for artists. And, you know, sometimes artists feel like, well, you know, Sergio, I'm overwhelmed. I feel like I have to be posting all the time, all day. And, you know, that's really distracting me. And then on the other side, you know, I have artists who say, well, Sergio, you know, I'm also overwhelmed because I feel like maybe I'm posting too much. Maybe I'm overdoing it. Maybe my audience is looking too much at, you know, too much content that I'm putting out there. So what do you think about that? So, you know, there's kind of like two sides and, of course, everything in between as well. So in this episode, I want to kind of share with you my opinion about that. And, you know, I have accounts in which I have posted, you know, I have a lot of posts in which I post, you know, sometimes 3 to 4 times per day. And I have accounts which I hardly post or very randomly. And of course, everything in between. And the reality is that the accounts where I post, you know, 3 to 4 times per day, which is a lot, you know, those accounts are growing a lot faster. You know, there's particularly one account in which that's what I'm doing. And since I started doing that, you know, the account has doubled in size. So there's no surprise to me that the more you post, of course, as long as your posts are on brand and, you know, you're not just posting random stuff, you know, that account is growing a lot faster than other accounts. Now, on my personal art account, Sergio Gomez Art, where you watch Breakfast with Sergio, and where you look at my art, for example, on that account, I post once or twice per day. So on a typical day, if I have Breakfast with Sergio show, I will post this episode, and maybe later today, I will post a picture of one of my artworks or something happening in my studio or something, right? So I like to have that variety between, you know, the content that I bring you to help in your art career and also my own art, right? So because I'm a practicing artist, not just a marketing guy. So that is kind of like the content that I put there. So it keeps me on that rhythm of posting every day. And that account has grown since I started doing that. And also it has created a beautiful community about what I'm doing because I love to engage with people on my personal Instagram account, which is something that I love to do. So, you know, I've noticed again, you know, how different accounts grow at different speeds according to the type of content and how much content I'm putting out there. So if you are afraid of overposting, maybe you're posting too much, right? Are you creating, you know, follower fatigue where they're seeing too much of your? I don't think so. And this is something that I've thought about before. And let me tell you why I don't think you can never overpost, right? Saturate the Instagram or so. And the reason is because algorithms are at play. Anyone that follows you is not only following you, but it's following, you know, probably hundreds of other people too, maybe hundreds of other artists as well. So you're not the only person that they follow you. Let's say I'm following you, right? And you're posting because maybe you're doing a promotion right now. And if you watch Breakfast with Sergio, you know, I talk a lot about the cycles in your marketing. There are seasons in which you need to push the envelope and do a whole lot more. And then there are seasons in which maybe it's good to slow down and enjoy being an artist, right? Don't have that pressure of being on social all the time. So maybe you're in one of those seasons in which you have something going on right now. Maybe you just did a release. Maybe you have a show coming up. Maybe you have an opening. Maybe you're doing a virtual event, whatever. And you have, you know, this need, like, I need to let more people know about it. So by all means, post more, right? So if I'm following you and you, let's say as you go on that season in which you are doing a promotion and you're posting, let's say, 3 to 4 times per day, if I'm following you, when I go to my Instagram, doesn't mean that I'm going to see all those 4 posts that you created today. Why? Because the algorithms prevent me from doing so. The algorithms are going to show me, you know, what the algorithm thinks I'm going to like when I'm going on my Instagram. And it's not going to show me 4 of your posts right away. Usually, it does, you know, depending on how much I have engaged with you, how many times I have liked your pictures in the past, that is going to decide if it's going to even, you know, show me one of you those 4 photographs or images that you posted today, right? So in that sense, there's no such thing as overposting, because again, algorithms prevent your own audience, your own followers, to see all your posts. And in fact, you know, you may do 4 posts today. I may see a post that you did if I follow you today, and maybe I see it the next one 3 days from now, right? If it has got some quite engagement. Also, because I'm on Instagram and I'm swiping up, and you are not the only person I'm following, right? It's not that I'm just gonna see your post, I'm gonna see also other posts. So we are lucky if when we put a post, if, you know, a large segment of our audience sees it, let alone, you know, when you are doing it sporadically. So in that sense, never worry about, okay, I'm overposting. Now, if the person who's following you is only following 3 other people, well, of course, they probably will see more of your posts because they're not following enough people or a larger segment that they have variety in their feed that the algorithm is showing them. So I never worry about overposting myself when I'm in promotion mode and I'm running, you know, something that I want people to see. I increase my number of posts per day, because that's a season in which I need to get the word out. I need to, you know, be seen to be remembered, right? I talk about this all the time, be seen to be remembered. So it is okay. And then once that moves on, and then I can go back and relax to my regular pattern of posting, and that is okay. So hopefully this kind of helps you to figure it out, to think about, well, you know, it's okay to increase your posts as you're doing a promotion because you want to be seen, and don't worry about, you know, overly posting, because there's no such thing. And then, you know, slow down as you move along. And at the end of the day, my friend, it's about how you feel, right? If posting causes you stress, and I know a lot of artists who social media causes them a lot of stress, you know, I think, well, you know, see what you can do to alleviate that stress. Things that you can do, for example, maybe schedule your post ahead of time. Maybe on Mondays, sit down, dedicate 2-3 hours on Monday to plan your post for the day, I mean for the week, and then schedule them. There are apps in which you can schedule your post ahead of time. You can use Creative Studio, which is totally free. It's made by Facebook, and as you know, Facebook owns Instagram as well, so it's a great app. It's not an app, but it's actually a platform on your desktop where you can log in, and you just do Google Creative Studio. You can log in, connect your Facebook, your Instagram, and you can, you know, automatically post, you know, schedule for the future. So, and there are other apps in which, of course, you can do that on your phone and everything else. So, you know, that kind of helps you. If that kind of helps you, may alleviate some of the stress of feeling that you have to post too much. So thank you, my friends, for watching this episode of Brave Heart with Sergio. Hope to see you very soon in the next episode. Please share this with all your friends. And if you want to check out all the resources that I have for artists, just go to my website at www.theartistnextlevel.com and check it out. Hope to see you very soon. Goodbye.